Derek Sagima. Hi, Dr. Brewer. Is vitamin K2 a reasonable tactic in one's overall plaque reduction approach? If so, how long should one take it? Nobody knows. But here's what I think. I've got half a dozen videos on vitamin K2. At first, I only looked at the randomized clinical trials that I could find. One of them was the most well-known, and I'm blanking on the name of the study. It was named after a town in the Netherlands, and it did show some effect. But in most of those studies, they didn't delineate K2 versus K1. I agree there's some K1 impact in there, but it's really mostly K2 that we're looking at in terms of plaque. And then I read a couple of books where they talked about, I won't say pseudoscience, maybe science ultralight. What they were talking about was vitamin K2 in ghee, dairy products from cows that had been fed grass-fed cattle, said it 1,000 times. But here's what happened. I started looking at the science around that, and I found that K2 is very important in a couple of enzymes, MGPA, I think is the name, or MGA, and osteocalcin, both enzymes which move calcium in and out of bones and in and out of other tissue. So maybe that's where people get the focus on calcium and K2. But here's what else is going on. I mean, those same enzymes, MGA and especially osteocalcin, have some sort of relationship with insulin resistance. So I do think that K2 works. I do take it. I take about, unlike supplement, your typical supplement where you'll see 100 micrograms per day, I take about 400. I take 200 in supplementation, and then I take another 200 in a natto powder that I add to my smoothie each morning. Here's the final comment. I actually did find a randomized clinical trial where they gave relatively young, I mean, I remember maybe 40s and 50s, men relatively healthy, other than having prediabetes. They gave them like 400 micrograms per day of K2 and saw a significant improvement in their insulin resistance. If you're thinking, well, why don't you make a video on that? I thought that must have been a year ago, and I've got a long list of videos I still need to make, obviously. So yes, short answer is yes, Derek. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just going to have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable, and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process, and that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got two levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrisk.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859-721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrisk.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.